Hello everyone, my name is Amir Khan. I'm a solution engineer at Micro Focus, and I welcome you to this introduction session to ALM Octane. Recently I've uploaded a video to the ALM Octane Academy doing the same but for the German speaking community, and received feedback that it would be great to have a similar session for ALM Octane for the English speaking community. So here I am with the introduction session to ALM Octane. It will be more also a deep dive session, how to get started with ALM Octane, how you can configure different things. We will look into the different modules, but before we go directly into the product, I wouldn't want to give you a short presentation on ALM Octane and why I see it as a solution from waterfall to DevOps and everything which is in between for the application development and delivery processes you can manage with ALM Octane. So let's get started and look first of all into several surveys we have done recently in one of our major events at Micro Focus Universe, and we asked around 50 users what are the development methodologies they are using, and this was really the result. So we saw that there were a couple of people voted for waterfall, others voted for hybrid, and some also went for agile. So we can see here a clear movement towards agile. Many customers are still on the transformation. They are moving from waterfall to agile, but this is not something which is happening from one day to the other. It will require time, it will require trainings, and also the mind shift need to happen, as the waterfall approach was very different than the complete agile and DevOps approach. And in order to get there, you need to have any kind of hybrid approach in between, and then do your transformation during the execution as well, and change your mind how you have looked into the thing. So this was a result which shows the trend towards agile. Still many companies are not there yet, and the hybrid implementation is still valid and needed. And waterfall will not be completely removed at all, because there are still companies who require the approach in order to run a waterfall development due to the regulations they have, and due to the process which is required to implement the solution they are providing. The second survey we asked our attendees was, just name three tools your teams are using, and this is the result we received. And it is not a surprise, Jira is the tool which is used by many customers and companies. I don't know a single company who do not have Jira. And also Jenkins is something which is very popular. We see the trend into Octane is growing. Selenium from the test automation tool is being used. UFT also from the test automation tool is very popular. LoadRunner Enterprise. I have to say, in this special survey, we had a lot of Micro Focus customers. So this also explains why we have we have here a lot of Micro Focus tools. But you find here solutions like you have Solution Manager, you have tools like Appium, you have tools like UFT Mobile, Visual Studio, you have PPM, ServiceNow, so different other tools. Also Azure DevOps is listed here. So the teams and the customers, the users are using different tools, and this makes it really complicated, because you have now a very heterogeneous environment with those different tools, and you need to make sure that those tools are also connected and not only providing point value to the teams who are using it, but also providing value to the whole project, to the whole program or even to the whole organization. So this is the difficulty we see currently in the application delivery management. You have the flexibility, and this is right. The teams need to have the flexibility to use the tool of choice. If it is for test automation, UFT, Selenium, or even Cypress.io, or any other solution like RunRex or Tosca, it is okay if users use the tool of their choice. And we only need to make sure that we are able to connect those tools into the overall process to see not only the point value, but also the contribution to the application delivery. So this was the second result I wanted to share. And the last one was really about automation. And with the focus on test automation, we asked the attendees, name just the percentage of automation you have in place. And you can see clearly, this is also reflecting the first question. So many customers are in the hybrid modes. They are in the need of defining the strategy towards automation. Still, many customers have not started. So 0 to 20%, a high number of customers is placed. But then you can see, okay, some have already started with automation and they are going towards this trend of highly automated environment. This is also one condition which is needed for agile, for DevOps. If you want to break down barriers, you need a high increase in automation, get rid of manual tasks as much as possible, and also as much as it makes sense for your process without harming and risking the application delivery, increase the automation rates. And not only increasing the automation rates because you like a tool ABC and you want to automate with model-based testing, or you want to do shift left testing. No, automation should serve your program, your teams, and it should not be the other way around. So your team should not be using a tool because they like the tool and there is not really a contribution to the process, there is not a contribution to the team. So this is something where automation becomes really important, to understand what I'm automating is one thing, but also, are we getting the return on invest on automation? Are we getting faster? Is my team able to increase or decrease the delivery time of a feature? Are they able to find defect much faster than with regression testing, which is performed manually? Are we able to find defects which were normally escaped into production? So all those topics need to be considered when you are introducing automation, and this is really something where you require an interconnected environment which brings all those tools together and provide value on top of it. So, and the way Micro Focus solved this solution by having those different methodologies with waterfall to agile, hybrid to DevOps, you have the different automation requirements and the different tools you are using. So the way Micro Focus is solving it is providing this blueprint. And this blueprint is like a Bible for your application delivery management. You can see on the top, we see the different phases. For this, here you can see we have the planning phase where you define really the portfolio topics, what is on your portfolio, what is the need you want to implement, what is the project, you look into the cost and resources and really define the goals and value stream topics you need, and then you go into the build and test area, which is then directly here, build and test and release and deploy, where all the value is created. So the development team plans the requirements or product backlog independently in which methodology you are working. You could be on waterfall, you could be on agile, and then the implementation happens. So the implementation is happening really here on the bottom side, where the teams are now starting to work on the backlog implementation, doing the planning maybe in Jira or they have tools like Azure DevOps. So those tools are really used to getting things done. Yeah, so you need to have a common understanding of what need to be planned and implemented, and then you use those tools to getting things done, making sure that everything which is on the backlog is also implemented. You go into your IDEs and start programming with different tools like Visual Studio, you have IntelliJ, Eclipse, and so on. So you have different tools which helps you to really implement the code. You commit it into a Git repository, source code repository, where again Git is the majorly used repository, but also some use SVN. And once the code is written, it is committed, and the CI like Jenkins and others, they build the solution, they build the application, and do the deployment part. So continuous integration and deployment is happening here, where not beside Jenkins you have also TeamCity, you have Bamboo, which is there as well. And most of the times in the pipeline, you have also the continuous testing part, where functional testing is part of performance testing as well as security testing. And this brings really everything together. So this is the real automation you require in a complete pipeline to not only build the application and providing the unit tests and sanity checks and so on, but doing the overall execution of performance testing, functional testing, as well as security testing in an end-to-end flavor. And then once your test cases are performed, you then decide if you are able to go or not go into the next phase. This is also very important, where you really bring in the results of your pipeline and decide to the next level and deploy it into a production environment by using a release management solution. And you can see here everything which is happening in this green square, this is where the teams are working. Yeah? And here you have the freedom of choice. So you have tools like Selenium for test automation. You have tools like LoadRunner, JMeter, UFT, and so on, which are used to automate different things. SonarQube, Fortify can be used. And below here, you have a very interconnected environment. Teams are really working, but you need to find out, okay, what is now on top of it? The tools which are used in this area are providing value to my teams. Yeah, so here I can see, okay, and the developer can work with their IDEs, they can work with the source code management, they have the integration into the CI, but am I still able to see the stuff what I have defined here on the portfolio level and the requirements and backlog which I've defined? Am I still able to see the end-to-end traceability? Am I compliant to my process? Can I have the full governance about all the activities what are happening here below? And here actually the lifecycle management layer comes in, where Micro Focus allows you to really connect all those tools which were on the bottom, which are on the bottom, where the application is created and tested, and bring all the data together into this application lifecycle management area, where you can do really then find the traceability. You can see what is the current progress, how the teams are performing. So this is very important in order to act quickly. And then once your application is deployed into production, you have also the service management part, which is also contributing to the lifecycle management. So this is a very important layer where you can track everything as part of your process. Topics from your continuous planning are contributing to this area, but also production insights are happening, and all the whole development part, deployment part is also contributing. So at the end of the day, the lifecycle management becomes the central place, the single source of record, by providing a holistic view, a unified view on everything which is happening from the planning during the build and test phase, release and deploy, and continuous operation part, and bring everything together to make visibility across the process. So this is really where Micro Focus is providing different tools. ALM Octane definitely has been the tool of choice for lifecycle management independently. If you are using Waterfall, Hybrid or Agile, this is the solution which will help you on long-term achieving your goals towards your application delivery process. But now let's understand, before we go into the product itself and introduce ALM Octane, let's understand why Octane is needed. Yeah, why you need to have Octane? You have today Jira in place. Maybe you have Azure DevOps. You have Quality Center, or you have other testing tools. So why ALM Octane is needed? Yeah? And in order to understand this now, let's move first and take a look on the evolution of ground transportation. So you can see the way human being have changed the transportation, the evolution. First, we were really on the personal area. We were mainly walking. Then you had a horse, cycle, motor bikes, and really a car. So this is evolution, how we improved ourselves in moving personally. And for the public transformation, you can see transportation, you can see here also different transportation types which were implemented in order to achieve a goal. Yeah? And also here a mind shift happened, yeah, because also technology was involved. So we had to bring in different regulations. While when you were walking, you don't need to have a traffic, yeah, because you are working. But like here with the motorcycle and the car, you have to have a fundament in place. You need to have a road. You need to have a regulated traffic system in order to move safely and reach target one to target two, and so on. So this was required. And when you look at the public transportation here as well, we introduced time plans. Yeah, when a bus is arriving, when a train is departing, you required a specific infrastructure. While as in the very beginning, we didn't really require this infrastructure because the technology was not there. Yeah? So, and this is also important to moving from the mindset where you wanted to just having the job done to really achieve a specific goal, yeah? By realizing a value and implementing the infrastructure in order to reach that goal. Yeah? So this is just from the transportation side how things have been evolved. Yeah? And same, you can look into the evolution of light bulbs. Yeah? So in the very beginning, we had the candle light, which was not really very stable. If there was wind, it leashed completely out. Then we introduced the gas lamp, the Edison lamp, the household favorite, energy saver, and now we have really next generation lights. So also here, different technology was applied to reach a specific goal, and the mindset need to be shifted as well, yeah, as well as the underlying infrastructure. So with the candlelight, I didn't require any kind of electricity system, while as when I go to an energy saver, I need to have a pre-requirement set in my household to implement it. I need to have a working electricity with security implemented. This mind shift was required to really build this evolution of lights and achieve the goals here as well. And the last one is very popular, the evolution of mobile phones, while as in the very beginning, the target was really to be mobile, yeah, to talk while you are going and be able to communicate on your way to somewhere and be able to reach people, even they are not at a specific place. And it evolved also over time. So with the introduction of internet, multimedia requirements increased. The mind shift happened from only being able to talk to someone to really embrace a technology with smart functionalities, being able to not only consume communication, but multimedia, geo services, you have emailing systems. So today, the mobile phone has become a central place in our, a central component in our life. And this was not always the case. Yeah. And similarly, the evolution is happening on development approaches. We had waterfall. We are still on waterfall, moving towards agile, require a hybrid approach, and then completely going into DevOps. The way we are doing it is really also transformative, and you need to consider that with waterfall, you need to have, you required a set of tools which was used by the disconnected teams. Yeah, so here on the waterfall side, you had teams for business analysts. They were working on tools which were really addressing their needs. Then you had the testing team, you have the development team, and they were completely isolated from each other. Yeah, while as here, these teams become more centrally, so they are more connected in an agile team approach and having cross-functional responsibilities. So this is also things where changes happened to the whole process, and these changes also required new tools. And the more you go to the DevOps area, you also need to make sure that now you are increasing here the automation rate. So we are having here higher automation rates than we had to have here in the waterfall environment. And with higher automation rate, it's not about just the deployment or the test area, but it's also about getting the data automated quickly and fast to the right place so that you can decide if things are going good and you can roll out or you cannot roll out to the production. And this is not done only by automating things, automating the deployment, but also bringing data together, having an interconnected application delivery management system. And here is really where Octane comes in. Yeah? So Octane was designed to serve the organization, to serve the program, and also to serve the implementation. Yeah, so you can have all the different integrations from your development team, from your planning part, and from your operations team into a central and unified area view, which will provide you all those automated decision-making basis for you to move on. And here also the mind shift happened as we are working with Azure DevOps and Jira, where the mentality is really on the backlog, the focus is on the team and getting things done, while as Octane is more on the level of providing the capabilities to realize the value. Yeah, so Octane is really about realizing the value of things which are happening underneath. Yeah, so here you have different tools where your teams are working just to do the job done. But once you have a centralized place like ALM Octane here on the top, you will see that here we are now focusing more on the realizing the value. So if you are not able to execute a number of tests which were required to have 100% coverage, then Octane allows you to really realize the value of not doing things. Yeah? What would be the risk then if you would not be able to execute everything? And this is really about automation, bringing the data into one central place to quickly do decision making. So that's the reason why we developed ALM Octane, and at the first place it was really developed for ourselves so we can do application delivery much faster, we can transform ourselves into a more agile and DevOps approach. And by doing that, we defined first why we need a new solution. Yeah? What should be the capabilities this new solution should serve? And this is now mapping back to the very first question we introduced to you about what are the methodologies organizations are using. And we saw that it is not only tied to one methodology. You will have, especially the larger enterprises, they will always be using a combination of different application delivery approaches like waterfall, hybrid, agile, a mix and match approach. So we need to require something where we said, okay, this solution platform should be able to support agile and non-agile teams, while it's on the same hand, it should be easy to use and work across browsers and any platform. While we need to have a huge number of tools in place, so it should be also open architecture, integrated and extensible. That's also one reason why we provide so many plugins for ALM Octane, and you can integrate basically any kind of tools into Octane as it has a very open architecture with the REST API and allows you to really integrate all the data points into Octane. Things we had was also about sharing. Yeah, so share the assets you create across teams. This is also something where Octane is very powerful. And as we are coming from the quality background, so the fundament of Octane is quality. Yeah, so it provides you a platform which helps you to identify what is the quality across your application lifecycle management and provides the right KPIs at the right time for you to quickly see how the current progress look like. And Octane was built as a DevOps design center. It's also a very interesting point. DevOps design center, what does it mean? At the end, if you unpack it, it is really telling you that if you are going towards a lean process, toward continuous processes and pipeline management, shifting your development from traditional to agile and DevOps, then Octane is the tool of choice. It will make things easier for you. It will make things clearer and integrate into your process much, much simpler than any other tool on the market. So here Octane brings in real DevOps capabilities and design center requirements which you can use to implement your application delivery process. It is tightly connected to the teams. This is also a very important topic to see the analytics, what my teams are doing by writing the code, by executing different test cases using different tools. So this is really where Octane connect everything into the quality. Yeah, this is really the quality management solution for application delivery management. And we do it by providing also a mining data capability and analytic, which will help you to speed up decision making. Under the roof of Octane is Elasticsearch, most probably the fastest search engine on the planet, and this helps us to really focus on the right data, mine the data at the right point, so you can benefit from the analytic area of Octane. And we do this really by adapting the different approaches, by integrating the teams and tools, allowing you to scale everything to your organization and embrace the methodologies, the tools your teams are using into a central repository, so you are able to benefit from the reporting capabilities. So Octane supports definitely large number of application delivery or development processes, whatever your flavor is. These are just three examples. If you are more on a traditional layer, you can use the waterfall approach and the modules which are required to implement the waterfall approach in Octane. If you are hybrid, go for the modules just with the plug and play mix and match approach into Octane. Or if you are completely agile and digital, you can make use of the right modules to support your teams and your process. So this is really flexible. Just three examples for you. You can mix and match. You can define your own combination of modules you want to use. This is really flexible, where Octane provides the right tools to your organization in order to be quickly and fast with the implementation and have a successful application delivery. For whom ALM Octane is a perfect fit? So it isn't a perfect fit for any team. It could be that you are more on a waterfall approach, then your business analyst will be very appreciating the capabilities ALM Octane provides for the requirements module by authoring the requirements, defining the test coverage, performing the test execution, tracking the defects, all in one place, in one view. No need to switch between the modules and bringing in all the connection points from your traditional approach into a single view. This is what Octane is capable of. If you are more agile, then a product owner can really define the backlog items that do the release and sprint planning together with the agile team. The developer can build the application, testers can test, build manager is involved, QA manager and IT operations as well. So this is where Octane brings the teams together by integrating their tools or allowing them to also work directly in ALM Octane without the need of any additional tool which is then implemented on a team level. Quality is basically everywhere, and when we talk about quality, we do not only talk about testing. For sure, testing is a major part to make sure that quality assurance is happening, but quality we connect to everything, and this from the very beginning. The moment you define a requirement, the moment you define a backlog item, you need to have a common understanding what are the topics you want to focus on, and the way we represent those topics are is application modules. So you can say, okay, I have my different application and I break this application down into several logical topics. This could be reflecting your functional modules on the application side, but this could be also reflecting your business processes. This is something when you need to think of quality with a more holistic view and providing the capabilities to track quality from the very beginning to the complete end product. So by connecting it to backlog and requirements, connecting the same to development, what is happening really on the dev side, bringing in testing pipelines and the traceability to allow the users to track everything at every time, follow up with topics which have been not implemented, and also identify coverage, risk, or any other bottlenecks in your process. So here's really very strong capabilities of ALM Octane, which can help you to make your application delivery much, much faster. Continuous testing is a big topic in today's time. You have different tools, different vendors who are pushing for this topic, and Octane makes it quite simple. Yeah, so we allow you to integrate with any test automation tool. It could be whatever tool you are having. If this tool can naturally talk to the supported CIs like Jenkins, TeamCity, then we are able to identify and integrate it easily. Otherwise, if this tool is maybe traditional or self-built custom framework you have designed in your company, then you can make use of the REST API to bring in the integration with your test automation tool. We support really basically everything, so open source to commercial tools, micro focus tools for functional, non-functional testing, but also security, unit system integration testing. So everything you can imagine, from waterfall environments to completely DevOps environment, every testing tool you have for any category is supported by ALM Octane. And we provide the right interfaces to integrate those tools directly in Octane. Also, beside the integration of tools, we support several frameworks like Cucumber for BDD, SpecFlow, and so on, but also JUnit and UNit testing frameworks are also supported. Now let's take a look on the broader integration of the DevOps ecosystem. So here you can see the different categories we are providing for the IDE integration with the most popular IDEs like IntelliJ, Eclipse, Visual Studio. We are supporting here source code management systems. So Git is the major one. Subversion is here GitHub, but with Git you can also integrate with Bitbucket or GitLab. This is possible. CI, you can see Jenkins definitely is one of the most popular CIs, but also TeamCity, TFS, GoCD, GitLab. Test automation is supported. Security, performance testing, and code coverage. And if you know you don't find a plugin here which is supporting the tools you have, you can see that all those areas have also some APIs interfaces which you can use to bring in the data from your custom tool, from your third-party tools which are not officially supported, still benefit from the central and unified environment by having the REST API, which is very powerful, and also the collaboration into Teams, Slack, Skype, and all the notification which you have in ALM Octane to allow a better collaboration between the teams. So this is not only the technical side of integration, but also from the team side. You can bring in the different users, notify them at the right time, and get the social aspect also in the application delivery. Besides the DevOps integration, we provide also cost-free synchronization with MF Connect, a separate platform for synchronizing management solutions like Azure DevOps or Jira or ServiceNow data into ALM Octane. And the way it works is for all ALM Octane customer, MF Connect is for free. You need to be entitled for ALM Octane or ALM QC, even the Silk products, if you are having them, then MF Connect is for free for you. And you can define the endpoints here, majorly on the, let's say, Octane side, and decide, okay, you want to sync with Jira, you want to sync with Azure DevOps, you want to sync with ServiceNow, then those data will be synced to ALM Octane. If you have here a backlog item, then this backlog item will be created in Octane. Then the backlog item is done, implemented, and maybe you have Azure DevOps, maybe not from the backlog tracking management, but you track maybe defects there. So if defects should be synchronized from Azure DevOps, they can be synchronized to Octane directly. Same goes for incidents from ServiceNow, can also be synchronized using this tool into ALM Octane. So this is really the way Octane gets information synchronized from different system, and you can benefit it by having everything into one single place. And this is really about the core. So here you can see more now the tools brought in than the view which we provided before. So all those tools can exist, coexist beside Octane when you are having a Jira or Azure DevOps, TeamCity. You can still allow the users to work on Jira and do the code commits on Jira items by using the different IDEs. Still, Octane is able to capture here on top all the traceability from backlog items from Jira to code which was committed in Git and built by Jenkins or any other pipeline, bringing in all the testing testing results into the intelligence of Octane, and making sure that you see everything in a central and unified flavor. Once everything is in production, also from the service management side, you can bring in the incident into the defects of Octane and measure the progress from your project portfolio side and see what is going on here on that specific area. So this is basically how Octane solves the solution, how Micro Focus solves the solution of bringing in all the connected environments together. And once you have it, then it's basically very easy. Octane provides different kind of reports and analytic like this heat map, yeah, and this could be representing your different or your favorite apps or your most critical apps, and you can see directly the size of the app make sure or represents how big or large the implementation is from the testing side, from the development side. So you can see here in this example, I have different applications like mobile store, like online store, like billing app, chat app, account search, and so on. And the largest one is here really the mobile store. Then I have two which are similar, account search and online store. And I can see from the colors that online store, wire transfer, account search, and here chat, they are having some issues based on the criteria I have defined. So here I have to really, I see directly what is happening by those interconnected system. And this data can be pushed from Jira, can be synchronized from Jira or any other automation tool you are having in place, like Selenium, Appium, you can have Tosca. All those tools can report into this heat map, and you can then even drill down those capabilities by the different areas, like commits, yeah, where you can see, okay, this is my same mobile store application, where I can see what are the risky commits, what are the test cases which were executed, the CI runs, same for manual test execution. You have here for the team effort. So you see basically everything what is going on those application or topics you have defined for you, and you're connecting the quality across the teams and tools underneath. This data can come in really from everywhere. The risky commits can come from Git. Here CI test run, this is automation, this can come from, it come in from Jenkins. Manual testing can be happening in ALM Octane directly. Team effort can come from Jira or Azure DevOps. Defects can live in Octane, but also in Jira or any other team tool. BDD coverage, this is from Cucumber, from your development environment, and you see the BDD documentation directly in ALM Octane. So you can see this makes things so much easier by interconnecting the whole development ecosystem and bringing the data into Octane, to really moving from the mindset of getting the job done instead of here really seeing and understanding the value underneath what is happening, and also based on this deciding what will be the impact if I am not going to fulfill here my online store. Are these test cases still issues for me? Then I can reflect here back to the area. So here I can see, okay, if online store, I have failing test, I have here also failing test, but still many are planned for online store. But here on the same side, I can see that online store has not so critical defects, so we can look into it and decide still to go to the next transition. Here automation is not increased, so maybe I should be able to, or I should be increasing the automation for my online store. And it helps you to identify really the value, what will happen if you do something or if you don't do something. This is really about realizing the value instead of just doing something in a specific manner. And once data is in Octane, you can really benefit from the powerful dashboards and generate any kind of team-specific, process-specific data, like the injection of defects coming in daily, the burn-up, burn-down charts, the release content pushes you may have in your environment, what has been delivered, what has been moved into production. All those data you can see in a central place and benefit from the capabilities of Octane. So that was just the presentation, and it was really a long one. Now let's go into the demo. In the demo, we will really focus on the different modules ALM Octane has but also the understanding where do I start. Basically, we have now listened to a lot of things, like we were able to see the whole quality topic, qualities everywhere. Having this in mind, where do we start? So we will really do a new project creation here, create our quality or orchestrate our quality before we go into the implementation. Then you can build the backlog modules, you can build the requirements module, we can look into the topics of importing requirement, importing backlogs, then connecting this to the testing area, and also allowing the user to really see the stuff they are interested in. So I don't need to populate all the modules to a normal user. It is enough if I populate the modules they need just to get started. So let's go into the demo now and see how we get started. So let's get started with the demo. I'm now on the landing page of ALM Octane, so I've logged in already, and what I can see here is on the landing page, I have here on the bottom three quick videos for introduction to the backlog module. So if you want to work with the backlog module, you can take a look here on this quick learning video. Then the pipelines and failure analysis, so if you want to integrate your CI servers and get some additional insights and analytic by Octane, you look into the pipeline and failure analysis, and then you have the test and quality management, which explains the overall approach how ALM Octane is taking for test and quality management. You have a couple of links here on the right hand side. These links allow you to quickly access, for instance, the What's New page, the online help. We have a very active ALM Octane community, so this is something what I can recommend. Also a LinkedIn group, which you can use to ask questions. Our ALM Octane experts are registered in this group. We have a marketplace, where you can download different plugins and example reports for ALM Octane based on OData or solutions which our partners are developing. So this is also a nice place which you can make use of to get additional solutions. And here the last link is about populating demo data. So basically what users often use is really the online page. This is something which is very often used, the community as well as the marketplace. So these are the links you should be most probably using more frequently. Here on the top, you can see on your user profile, you have here an area where the project is listed in the project where you are currently logged in. So let me open the profile now. And in the profile, you can see that I have a couple of options, especially for my user, to either change the language. So it's also cross-language solution, ALM Octane. You can change also the theme, dark mode or the standard mode. Additionally, you have here all the different projects where you as a user are assigned. So this is really encapsulated, and you are only seeing the projects where you have access rights and read rights to. All other projects you won't see. So it's really something where Micro Focus ALM Octane allows you to build a multi-tenancy platform to also strictly isolate data which might be sensitive to others which are not so sensitive. So this is really something you can organize based on the different workspaces and shared spaces. We have here a help page, help icon, where you can jump directly on context specific help by clicking on help on this page, or visit our online help center. We have an interactive client as well as here some kind of relation Explorer for REST API. So basically what you can do is here the online help. This is very useful. Yeah, so here you can visit it by clicking on the online help, and you have here a lot of different areas like how to get started quickly. Here you will find the system requirements, etc. User help about the different topics ALM Octane can implement, the integration, how to install, configure, developer documentation, and videos. And under videos, you have also the link to the Octane Academy. It's also very important to find the area where you get and receive all the different helps, additional topics. So this is a growing channel. We are posting here on a weekly basis, multiple videos, so it's worth to look into this as well. And the best way to use the Academy is really if you are looking, let's say, for something in a specific categorized manner, then you can either scroll down and you can see here the different categories which are appearing. So get started, where you have tip of the week, general topics, user discussion, user session, and so on. So working with the different modules, you have continuous integration here and testing, which you can use to really see how the developer should be working, how to work with pipelines, test runners, BDD, with UFT tests, Selenium. So all this you can explore here, reporting dashboard, customization workflow. So all this you have access directly from the YouTube channel. And now let's assume you want to search for something specific, then you can enter here. Let's enter here Jira, then it will directly filter me all the videos from the Academy which are related to Jira. Or if you say you want to see something about Selenium, then enter Selenium here and it will update the videos, or it will show you the videos which are really related to that content. So this is what you can make use of on the Academy site. And additionally to the videos we are providing on the Academy, you can see here in the channel information, in the About section, you have a link call for Udemy courses. Yeah? So here you can see you have the ALM Octane Udemy courses. So basically this is a collection of the videos which already exist on YouTube, but they are put in a sequence and put together to a course, which can be very useful for you if you want to learn Octane. So we have here a course for basic how to work as a developer. You have here, for if you are coming from ALM Quality Center, so this is a course really planned for ALM Quality Center users. If you want to learn the business rules customization or the backlog items, you can make use of those courses. SAP specific test management, you have here the basic of test management itself. So this is something you can use, or working with REST API. So these courses are also available and accessible directly from the Academy channel. And then you have also some additional references with customers who are using actively ALM Octane. So you can read their story as well. So this is just a brief introduction to ALM Octane and how other customers are using it. You receive your best practices and so on. So this is where you have the one area of gallery you can consume and see what's going on. So let's continue here. You have then the wheel, which allows you to go into the customization. But this is also important because most of the times you want to know, okay, if I want to go to want to import data from Excel to ALM Octane, this is really here in the import section. You can see these are data types you can import. You can import backlog items, you can import tests, you can import requirements. A format should be Excel. Then you have the possibility to here look into the document generation. So once you are working in ALM Octane and you have entered all the data, the teams are working together, and now for a specific release, for instance, you want to extract the data to generate a document, then this would be the section you will look into it. Then we have some management topics here, like environment list, test assignment rules, where you can also define external actions, so buttons for ALM Octane, and some user specific preferences you can have here, some configuration you can make as a user. So, and then you have the part here when you click on the modules on the hamburger menu for home, you see that a lot of modules open, and this is an administrator view. Don't get irritated, it's really something you can isolate for your users. So you can configure Octane like that a specific user sees only the backlog module or only the requirements module, only quality. So this is really an admin view you see now, but to explain this more in a more concrete way, you can see here on the left hand side, you have three modules. You have the My Work module, you have the Dashboard module, and you have the Issues module. These modules are commonly used, means independently if you are working from traditional approach or agile approach, in any way you will have to access these modules. My work is basically telling you what is the work for the logged in user, so what is he working on. The dashboard module is really about reporting and building the dashboards in a way either publicly available for the whole user group in the project or only for the single person who is logged in. So dashboard is very useful, and issues is really the issues which are occurring during the testing, but also security vulnerabilities. If you want to track those, these are listed here. So these are the three common modules, and then you have in the middle some modules which are more process related. So like you have here the requirements module, and requirements is really something you would use for traditional implementation. So if you are working with waterfall, you would use here a requirement for it. If you are working, let me change the color, so we change here. So waterfall would be requirement, and this basically allows you to do everything you were able to do in Quality Center or ALM. So ALM QC is really everything what you were able to do, from defining the requirements, you can see here authoring and management of requirement, the whole coverage analysis, you have the test coverage here, you can do the execution, and what is not written here but you can do it anyway is the defect management. So you can also have here defects and track them completely in the requirement. So all the other modules you would not need if you are working in a traditional approach. Requirement is enough, and this would also be the module you would look for providing to the end users. If you are working in a more agile flavor, then for sure you go here with the backlog module. If your agile teams, the development teams, are also working in Octane, then you can use the team backlog module. Difference between backlog and team backlog is the backlog is really the product backlog, representing the product backlog with all the higher level topics, and the team backlog is really the implementation topics which are occurring during a sprint. So this is something you can use, and again, you don't have to use any quality module in combination, because one thing you will identify in Octane is that one module is common. So you have in this approach, you can have the test here, you have test, and this is really completely integrated in those modules and views. So this testing is really something which is common and allows you to really work in a specific flavor. If I would now show you a different view, like this is a completely traditional approach. In this requirements module, this is what I need when I'm coming as a Quality Center user into Octane. I was working with requirements, test plan, test lab, defects, test execution. Then I have everything here. This is my go-to module and view, and additionally I can have the dashboard and my work module and some issues. So if you want to isolate the defect completely, you have here a separate module, but Overall, it is context-driven and visible here. You could also make sure as a test manager, maybe not only as a tester, as a test manager, you can say, okay, I have here, on the one hand, I have the requirements module, because this is more the subject perspective, the business perspective on the implementation, and I have the quality module for the test manager. This is the application perspective you are bringing in by really doing the same thing. So here you have the structure from your business, and the tests are the same. So the test you are using here, you can use in the quality module as well and map it to your application topics. The tests which are created here in the application modules, you can use them and map them to your business requirements and functional requirements here in the requirements module. So this is really the flexibility. You can go either with one module only, or you can extend always to another second module. So the quality module is very important in order to orchestrate quality across your lifecycle. It makes sense to use this at least together with one of the requirements modules, so either requirement or the backlog. If you say, no, I want to have a complete team viewer, I have a developer who is working in or who will work in ALM Octane, then this would be the view a developer would see, because in the team backlog, as he is implementing code, he would see all his backlog items, what he's currently working on, and once his code is completed, he could do also some acceptance testing directly in Octane. He could make use of the commits and pull request functionality in Octane to identify what code has been written for which user story and defect. He has a task board where they can work on, and the pipelines module to really integrate the application build with all the insights of a pipeline job. So this would be a developer option you would provide to your users. Or you say, no, we have a complete agile project, we don't need the quality, the application side of you, we do everything in Octane. So you would define this then as a product backlog, and the team backlog would represent your sprint backlog. And if I would compare this to existing market solutions, so this would be like Jira plus X-Ray or Sapphire plus additional functionality, because Octane is not only providing you the capabilities of building the backlogs, but also allows you to see the whole thing around traceability, the coverage, matrix on reports, and pipeline insights. So this is really something where Octane provides provides all the solution to replace these tools directly. So now let's go back again, and we were still talking about how to get started with ALM Octane. Yeah? So one of the first thing you need to consider when you are working with ALM Octane is for sure you need to take care of the release management. So you need to define a release with the timelines, and also if you want, you can define some release processes to get started. But where is the right area? Yeah. So what we will do now, we will go into the customization, and from the customization we will go into the spaces. So let me go here. So here I'm already in spaces, and what I will do, I will go now on the shared space and create a new project, and this will be a normal ALM Octane demo project. I can configure a couple of things, but I won't do it here. Just my user and another test user I want to configure here, and let's say add. And now the workspace is being created and the users are assigned. So you can see this was really very fast, so it's already done. And the two users which I have assigned are both admins, so I did a mistake. I need to make sure that one user is not an admin. But let's first concentrate on the project itself. I have two users. One user I would like to have only a dedicated view. Yeah. So let's say my second user should only be doing requirements, and we will be implementing a waterfall approach where we define requirements and do the test coverage and also map the quality for the users. But this user does not see the quality module, but still I would like to I would like the user to contribute to the heat map. Yeah, so this is also something which is very interesting in ALM Octane, to provide the possibility to create these kind of heat maps, because this is the application perspective, which shows me exactly what is going on, what are the different applications or application modules I'm having, and I want to have a one view, unified view, which tells me the overall progress. So this is something what I want to have, but the second user should only be seeing this view, and by using this view I want him to contribute to the heat map. Yeah, so let's see how this can be established. I will go back into the definition. So first of all, what I need to do in my group permissions, let's define the view. Yeah? So in the on the shared space level, you can see here under permission you have here the different groups, and I will go for a group, let's say it is called requirements maybe. Here under requirements you can see I have this visibility, so only requirements I can see, dashboard and the defects. I could also add here maybe release management if I want, and the processes, but for me it is okay. So requirements is good, and on requirement level I want this user to allow him to create every test case. This is fine. Automation, not really. I don't want him to create automation. Manual testing is fine. Execution is fine. I can define the backlog. So on the backlog, he can only create defects, which is also good. Requirement, he should be able to do everything. Application module, he cannot create application module. So he is not the owner to provide the application insights on the heat map here. So these topics, he should not be able to define. Yeah. So this is okay. Release management, I don't want him to do it. So the rest should be fine, I guess. So this is already defined, and what I can do, this is important, the module visibility, because in the module visibility here I'm telling ALM Octane that this user group is able to see only the module requirement, defect and dashboard. These are the modules this user group should be seeing, and if I go here into this project, you can see requirement, dashboard, issues. This is a module which is for the user, so it's available anyway. Yeah, so once I've done it, I can go here to users, and in the users let me find the second user who is currently as an admin in this workspace. So workspace admin, let me go in and say this user is not workspace admin anymore, but he should be doing the requirements here. So he should be seeing only the requirements. So let me save it. And now I can switch the project. So let me refresh my browser. Okay, my mouse is not working. Let me check. Okay, now it should be possible. So I switched into the wrong space, but this is okay. Here in the ALM Octane demo, I can switch again. So it will load the project for me, and I will now look into the modules and see what are the different modules this user is able to see. So here you can see I'm in the project, and this is what this user is able to see. I can see the requirements, I can see the dashboard and the issues, and if I go into the requirement, what I basically see is I'm here in the authoring mode. Currently it's all empty, and here I have the manage mode as well, and it works basically the same manner. Currently it is a traditional project, but if you would be, let's say, in a more agile approach, the same tools will be required from you. Yeah? So let's go here back in the requirements module. What do I mean by the same tools? First of all, what you will see also in the backlog module is here this tree. This is a context tree, and this helps you to really define your structures and set things into context. Yeah? So here you can have different topics, what you want to build, create different structures and hierarchies here if you want. So this is where the context will be provided from you. In the middle, this is the working area. Yeah? So I will mark it blue. In this working area, you can create a standard overview, yeah, with all the different or your most important graphs, where you want to map the context to. Yeah, so everything you define here is put into the context you have defined here. And on the very right side, you have another panel, which is more for the filtering area, and here you can have also an additional context. So you have two context areas. Majorly, this is more the time specific context, like releases or milestones, while as this is the context of your content, the requirements and the topics you want to cover, and both apply to the middle area. So on the one hand, right hand side, you can create your structures and point on a structure. The middle area will be updated in the overview section, and again, after you have set here the context, you can come here and say, okay, I would like to filter now the area here by releases or by whatever, then the middle area gets updated as well. So this is the approach what Octane has in every module to provide simplicity and flexibility to get started quickly, and just everything is one click away. Once you have defined the structure, we will see it later on. It's really very easy to work with. So once I have done it here already, what I can also do is I can, let me create a simple structure. Let's say this is my LM Octane demo folder. And in the demo folder, I can now go here and create a new requirements document. So let's say this is a business requirement document, and this is not a folder, it's important. Yeah? So here I can select the requirements document. Now you see it changes a bit, which is okay. I'm the owner, it's fine. So I say I've added it, and here on the requirement document I can now add test cases. I will not add it because I will delete it. We will import requirements, but anyway, I will show you what I want to do. Yeah? So currently I can add a test case, and here I have the possibility to select application modules. Yeah? My application modules are empty currently. Yeah, so this is not going to work, but let me open it again and go into the quality module, not from here, because I have the administrator and I want this guy to really contribute to the application module. So let me switch the project, and this guy is the administrator. So I'll be creating the application modules. And let's imagine we are in a SAP environment where we want to create different modules. We want to implement different modules like sales and distribution, like financial accounting, material management. So we will create those here now using admin user. So now I'm in the project now, and the first thing I do is I go into the quality module, and let's keep it simple. You can see here again, I have the same tree. Yeah, similarly to the requirement, this is my context tree. Here I built my structures. Then I have the filter tree here, filter area, which also provides here the content of the working area. So this is the combination I can use, and these three I can really collapse and expand. This is the nice part about ALM Octane. And now let's build it. So I want to build an application module. Let's say this is for my sales topics. I can provide here a business impact, but this is for a future feature we are going to release. I will ignore it for now. Let's say I have sales, I have finance, and I have another one which is, let's say, logistics. So these are my modules, and you can see I've created those three here. And if I go back now to the other user, create another manual test or try to create another manual test, for sure I need to refresh here. Let's refresh. Do it again, and now you should be able to see here. Okay, sales. So here it is there, but it's not refreshing. Let me reload the page. So you can see it has been reloaded, and now I should be able to see the different structure. This is exactly the things I have created here. So these three topics are now visible here. And this user does not has the access to the quality module. Yeah? So they cannot really create, and this is also not the need, because this is the subject view, the business view from the requirement. So the application view has been created by another user, but now the user who is managing the requirement can provide the content related to the modules of your application you want to test. So the moment he goes here and say, this is my test 01, and I select, you know, he could create now a test without selecting the module. So this is also something what I would advise: you make this field in general as a required field. Yeah. So before you start, make sure that this application module field is required in every other module. It could be on business, on backlog items. Whenever a test is created, this is mandatory. Yeah? So this would be a good way to allow testers and other users to contribute to the application module. So let's do it again. We go here in the customization area again, and I select the project itself. And in the project, I can now go here to the manual test. And in the manual test, I can create a new rule where I say I want to set an action which is make required. And what I want to make required are the fields I can select from here. So let's say this is a manual test, and I would like to, is it a manual test? Let me check. No, this is a manual run. I was on the wrong area. Here, this is the manual test. And on the manual test, I would like to make again a field required, and the field of choice is application module. With this, I really force everyone who is creating a test to select an application module. Yeah? So this is important. So let's go back here, do a refresh here as well as on this area. Let me do it like this. Maybe it already helped. No, it didn't, but when I refresh here, it should help. So, and if I click now on add manual test, you can see this field is required. So this is very important. Let me give you a short example. So let's say test 01, and this belongs to sales. Add another one, then test 02 belongs again to sales. You can also say I want to have here multiple, is also possible, sales and finance. I have customers who say, no, I want one-to-one relationship between the modules and the test. But if you have tests which are going across modules or across applications, you can definitely select here multiple. Yeah? So let's do it here, another one. And then I have, let's say, test 03. This goes to finance, and test 04 will be in all. Yeah? Test 04 is in all three. So now the tester or the user has contributed now 4 test cases to this business requirement specification. It is now very interesting. What happened now? Yeah. So the first thing already the user can see is if he goes here in the dashboard module and get rid of everything what is represented here. And now create a new widget. Let me also format it here. Let's say we are on 100% format. And here I create a new widget for the quality by application module. You see currently it's empty, but we need to configure it. And let's say in the display, I say default release is okay, or I get rid of it. And then I can say I want to have first level application module. Yeah. And I want them to be by the number of test, yeah, not by the size, it's not by user story points, but by the number of tests. And here I can say, okay, if I have more than 5 defects matching a filter, then the box will become red, otherwise it's green. And this is the approach I can take to really define my criteria and represent it here directly in Octane. So the moment I click on save, you will see it will build something, yeah, and things are built based on this number of test cases. So I can see here sales is my biggest topic, yeah, which is, let me go back here 1 second, in the requirement module again. So sales is my biggest topic, then I have finance, and then I have logistics. So let's go back here in the requirement module for this user. So you see here, if I go under manage, these are my different test cases. And the test cases are linked to different application modules. You can see these application modules here. In total, I have 3 test cases contributing to sales, 1, 2, 3, 2 to finance, and 1 only to logistics. And this is what here is represented. The smallest part is logistics, then we have finance, then we have sales. And now based on this, the first thing you have to do in the module we are working on, we are currently on requirement here, but you can do the same on backlog module, clean your overview tab and now build based on your needs here the areas. So what I will first create, I will create, let's say, a test where I say, okay, I want to have the defect severity by requirements. It's a valid graph I want to have here, where I filter only the 2 phases, and also filter here by the first level requirement, or I can also say the direct requirements which are attached to the defects should be displayed. And also I want to see, no, this is fine. Then the second thing what I would like to see is the test coverage. So I can go here and say show me, or let's create a new one, test coverage for requirements. And what I basically do here is I will say I want the test itself, so test cases, and what I want to filter on is the x-axis should be the covered requirement direct ones, and also show where it is empty, so I'm able to identify what are the requirements which don't have any test. And I would like to display the phase of the test. If the test is in new phase or wherever, then I'm able to see it. So when we go here, we can see currently here I have 4 test cases on this requirement. So this is built. And now I want to also see how the requirements are impacting my application module. Yeah? So this is also something which could be very interesting for me. So let me create a new one and say it will be a custom graph requirements by, I will say, indirect app modules, yeah, by quality. So let's represent it by the requirements. And for the requirements, what I would like to have here is, 1 second, this is the wrong area. It shouldn't be by requirement, it should be by test. Again, I would like to have here the application module, the first level application module, and I want to group by, let's say, requirement. direct requirement, this is fine. And basically, this is what I see when I am here on this folder. I see that the business requirements document is touching different application modules in my applications. This is a very important information for me to really have the mapping from the business to the application. So this I can now maybe move up. And another chart what I can make use of is maybe the test execution by requirement. So let's say execution coverage. On the one hand, I had the test coverage, and now this is the execution coverage where I select the last runs. And in the last runs, I can now decide, okay, the first thing what I want to see is the covered requirement. Yeah. Also show me the coverage where it's empty, and I would like to have it by native status. So save it, and now you can see currently execution coverage is not there, but this would be my view on things for now. Yeah, and as a next step, there should be also a release where I should be planning and running my implementation for. So currently you can see I don't have a release. So this is something also what the admin can define. Yeah, so I can go here now as an admin user into the release management process, and I will define a simple release. Let's say this is waterfall straight, yeah, which is just a Kanban release. And here I just say it started yesterday and will end next week, yeah, whatever. So now I have also a release I can make use of. And coming back to the user, now this user can say, okay, I am here on the business requirement document and I want to assign this to this release, waterfall. Okay, save it, and now go back again here to test, and let's plan some test for execution. Yeah? So I will create also another requirement. Let's say we create two more requirements, yeah, req 1 and req 2 directly under this one. So req 2 add, and now what I will do is I will map those test cases to the other requirements. So let's unlink it from here, unlink those tests which I have from the parent, unlinked, and now I can say req 1 is mapped to this and req 2 is mapped to the other two requirements. And now if I go back here to the structure, you can see already how it is represented. Yeah, so the impact on the different application module I can see either by requirement, or maybe it's better to switch the field. So here it should be covering requirement. So this is the covered content, and here on the bottom I have the application module first level. So maybe it will switch. Exactly, this is the way I would like to have it, because now I'm here on the context, a business requirement document, and I see what is below, what's going on below. Currently I have for both the requirement different test cases, and if I continue to work on the test cases, let's assume I go in one of the tests and say in the preview move it to design, the other one will also be moved to design, and one of them will become now move to review and ready. And here I have also some changes done. Look how it is impacting. This is important. You know, now I can see that something is going on in the coverage. I had defined my requirement. This is my application to requirements mapping. Then this is my test coverage. What is going on here? I have already one test which is ready. Other is in design. And now I can go into the test itself and define also. Let's say this is step 1 and I have step 2. That's it. Fine. And now let's plan those tests to be executed. Yeah? So, but before I plan those tests, let's move also the requirements. So I will assign the requirements to releases. So let's say here waterfall. And this is also waterfall from my point of view. This is okay. And let's compare again, you can see on this business requirement document, this is the current view. And if I put in a filter with the waterfall, you see currently nothing is going on. I have only here the requirement which are assigned, but they are not really tests which are planned for this release. So that's why everything is empty. And let's now do the planning of the test for execution. And I will just do it simply. I just plan a single test for the waterfall release and say plan it. Now you will see this is my overall view. I have already in the overall view, I have one test planned for requirement one. You see how easily and quick it is acting. And now I select the waterfall. And as the test is planned for this release, I can see for rec one, which is impacting the sales area of my application, one test is planned. Yeah. And here this test was ready actually. Yeah. So let's do it for the others as well. So let's say here I plan this test. Oops, I planned it as well to the same release waterfall. Now let's see what's happening. Rec 2 came in, now impacting the finance. The test is still in design, but it is planned, yeah, which is okay. Now as we go on and move forward, what I will do is I will execute one of the planned runs. So if I go here on this test and say run, it will not use a planned run. It's important information. It will create a new run and the planned run will exist. So what you have to do, you have to really go here to the planned run and then let's run it, either going on the run. I will just do it for now directly from here. I will pass this one. Yeah, so let's say it's passed. Refresh. So it's green and here I would be able to see it. For rec 1, one test is already passed. And let's continue. We run now the next one, which is test 2. I will execute now really like this and let it run. And here I will just say it's failed and I create a defect. A simple defect, let's say defect 1, yeah, and it is having a critical severity. I can say this is a pre-release defect. If I have additional information, I can paste it as my test is empty, nothing is pasted. I can also insert additional fields like current release, yeah, because this is the release where I detected the defect, yeah, waterfall. But here I can say when I want to fix it. Let's say it's also waterfall. This is fine. But now one interesting thing happened. Because I've executed a test on the application module for sales, you can see here sales is automatically selected, the application module. And this is what where Octane brings the automation of data connection in for you to allow to see exactly what is going on your application level. And the moment I click on add and stop the test execution, it will fail here. But now a couple of things happen. It was not only the link to the application module, but it also linked the defect to the requirement automatically. So if I go here to the requirement itself, click on the requirement ID, for instance, and click here on relation, you can see that the defect which was executed or which was found on a execution is directly linked now with the requirement. And this helps me a lot now by understanding what is going on here. Currently, it is a defect is opened. I can see here execution coverage is one is failed. It's all on the business requirement. Yes, if I go in the business requirement, dive more deeper, I can see where those issues are happening. Yeah, so even it was represented here on the business requirement, but now it is here on the rec 1, and rec 1 has this failure. Rec 2 still tests are planned. So what I can do now is I can really continue to work on this defect which has been found. So let's say at some point someone goes in and say this defect is fine. We go to the next one. Let me save it. And at some stage this defect is fixed. So this is also fine. And the moment the defect is fixed, the tester can go in and run the test case again. And after running it, I will just pass it now. So you can easily see how I will clean up the thing. So test is passed. I can recommend to close this defect. Yeah? So we can go here into preview and say propose close, which is fine. And if I go back now, you can see defect disappeared because the filter was here on new and opened for the release, which I have selected here, waterfall. If I uncheck the release, you can see it's still no defect because filter is on new and opened. But for the release waterfall, the defect is fixed and here the test cases are green. So this is really a great way to quickly get started and see immediately what is going on your different process. We found the defect and now we have completed and finished everything. And if I go now here to the area of my application modules of the heat map, let me define here the release, which is okay. And on the release, you can see currently everything is green. And let's do it again. We execute now this test we have here, which is planned for the other requirement. And on this test, I will create again a failure and create a defect to see how it is impacting now the other module, the dashboard module with the heat map. So let's say this is defect 02. Severity is high. It's a pre-release defect. I would like to have the release as well here, current release. And the current release should be the same from my point of view. This is fine. I think that's it. Let's stop it. And if I go back again here, I can see test is failed. I need to refresh my overview. You can see test failed. A new defect occurred on rack 2 this time, which is automatically linked. Rack 2 went to red. And now in my dashboard, if I want to understand where this defect is happening, I can see finance went to red. Yeah? And this is actually also displayed here. If I am on the requirement or on the defect itself, on the defect, and I want to see the application module, you can see it's on finance. So this is how things are interconnected with each other, entities are interconnected, so you are able to quickly identify the problem. The moment a problem occurs, it is real time fetched into your graphs and reporting, so you are able to understand where those things are happening and how you could act and react to fix those things. Yeah. So this is just a quick introduction how to use a waterfall approach without the quality module, because the heat map is still built for the same user. You can see I am able to see the heat map. Even my user does not have the permission to see the quality module, but still I don't need to have it because the quality module is maintained by someone else who has the better understanding of the application. I'm the business guy. I'm taking care about the requirements, and Octane provides me the capability to connect and interconnect the data with the right points so we can view it directly here. And now one more important thing is the moment I move forward, I create those kind of widgets and graphs, and I would like to share them with the other user. Yeah? For instance, if this user who's the admin now goes into the requirements module, you can see here he sees the structure. And he can also move into the manage module, but the things he sees here are not the same things the user who are working has is seeing. So what I can do as this user is I can say I would like to, let me release the filter, so like this. I would like to save this filter this favorite as a filter, and let's say this is my general requirement view. And actually, this user can only define private filters. So here the permission is missing. Let me give him the permission quickly. It's the administration permission. So he's able to share favorites with other user groups. So let me go here to the permissions. We go to the requirement user group. And this requirement user group should be able to see general actions, share favorite with all, share favorite with teams. Okay, and now the user just need to reload his page. Let's see here, reload. So page is reloaded, customization is applied, and I can now see that this user is able to share public favorite with everyone. So let's say here, this is my requirements general favorite. I want to share it with everyone, save it. And I can go now here to this admin user. And from here, I can say load a new favorite, click on favorite for publicly shared, and then load the favorite from the other user. And you can see it's exactly the same view. So the work this user has done is now shared with everyone within this project. Even other users have a different view or see different modules, but this is how you can really distribute information, share information with other user groups. So all of the team has the same understanding on the current progress and activities which are ongoing. And same you can do basically also for the dashboard module, where you can say, okay, I have here a dashboard module. Let me add maybe this view. And we add also on the bottom two more graphs. Let's say one would be the, let's select maybe some of those here. We have quality, open defects by application module, sounds interesting. And here I will just get rid of the status, as we don't have much application modules. So we can see here two application modules. Manual testing progress I want to see. So this is basically what is going on in my current project. I can switch the view. And I would like to also see maybe here, let's go to content planning. No, let's create a new one, which is requirement execution coverage. So let's say here we have the last run. I don't want the pipeline runs to be yes, this is okay. And here I can say covered requirements. So all my requirement, no, I want to have only the second level requirement. This is okay. And here native status, which is also good. And now I can see this is my second level requirement. Let's go to the direct coverage. I think in this one, it's easier. Yeah. So, and this would tell me exactly the current execution coverage for my requirement. And now this is a graph I have built. What I can do now is I can say I want to save this graph to be generally shared. Generally shared. One second. The information is not loaded. The customization on this tab was not loaded. So I'm just refreshing my browser. Now if I go back again here, I can share with anyone and generally general dashboard. I can also save it by release 1.0, but then I have to apply the release filter in all of those widgets. Currently, I'm not going to do it. So this is my widget as a user who is working really in the project, implementing the business view of the requirements, test coverage, execution coverage. Now I've shared this with someone who is on the administration side. So this user can now load the favorite directly into Octane and has also the same view what already one user has been working on. This is how quickly and easily you can create create entities, structures, and get the right reporting set for your project so you can directly identify the bottlenecks and see what's going on your project. And this works the same manner for all the other modules. So we saw just an example for waterfall project without the quality as the user is not using it. But you can do the same for backlog module as well. Or if you want to go with team backlog, go with team backlog. Do the same things in a more agile flavor. It's also possible. And it will work in the same manner like we have done now with the simple user here in this demo project. So this was just a really small introduction, how to set up, how to get started with Octane. There are a lot of other things you should be taking care of, especially when looking into the details of test execution. What I can recommend is the Octane Academy is here really a good source of record where you can say, okay, I want to see run test, for instance. Yeah, so you can see here how to plan and run a test, run automated test. You can say also plan test. Then you can see plan multiple test suite at once. So there are different things you can really consume based on the topics you are interested in. Go to the Octane Academy and you will find the right topic covered with the right detail. So this was the quick introduction of ALM Octane, showing you how the methodology is behind this solution and how the tool should be prepared when you are getting started, where you should be focusing on. So from my perspective, it's really the key with working with Octane is here. Yeah. So the more detailed you set up your quality module, the faster you will be. The faster you will be by building requirements, but also by building test cases and covering them with the quality module. And whenever you create a new run or a defect based on the test execution, the quality is also linked automatically to defect, and the defect for sure is linked also to the requirement. So this is really everything is about quality in ALM Octane, and you don't need to make this module visible to users who are not having the rights to see it. Manage it centrally by one, two users who understand the application structure, the application modules of your application under test, and provide it then to the business community, to the business users who are working with requirements, or even the teams who are working with backlog items. Give them the view to allow the test cases to be mapped to the quality here. This is very beneficial. And once you have set it in Octane, it's really a matter of clicks to get the right reports extracted from Octane and getting started so quickly in the dashboard module, but also here context specific. If you want to see what's going on, you can really set here the right filter and get the data right off Octane directly and see also where you are currently staying. So this is how to get started with Octane.